Antonia.
Vicente Rebaño.
We'll give you the best information and news of the moment. Let's start.
What is feminism? Feminism is a series of political, social movements, ideologies that share a common goal. This goal is defining, establish, and achieve political, economic, personal, and social equality between sexes. Now, I leave you with our corresponsal. She is going to take some opinions from the MEDE students of the Universidad Autónoma de Madrid.
Hi, good afternoon, audience. I find myself in the Medical University Zacatelco, and I will ask people who think about feminism. Come on. Good afternoon. My name is Fanny. I am a student Mason. Can I ask for a question?
Yes.
What is a feminist for you?
In my opinion, feminism is a social movement that rebels and criticizes the inequality that exists between men and women. Claiming and promoting the rights and interests of women. This movement arises as a consequence of conscience due to the subordinate status of women, and in today, which they have occupied the previous decades. Goodbye.
Let's go to find more maker students. Hi.
Hi.
Good afternoon. My name is Fanny. I am a student Mason. Can I ask for a question? What is a feminist for you?
I believe that feminist is a movement that represents equal rights between men and women and provides the same social, economic, and politic opportunities for both and men and women, favoring women in particular against society. Promoting equality.
Thanks. Do you consider yourself to be feminist?
I consider feminism. No, I don't consider a feminist.
Why?
I don't consider machism because I think in the equality form of things. I think that men and women want equality for the gender. I consider equality.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Fanny. I am a student Mason. Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Do you consider yourself a feminist?
I don't consider myself a feminist.
Why?
I think there are different people already have men or women. I only respect the way of thinking of people, and I like my life, that is what I should care for everyone that I think.
Thanks. I'm reporting for What's New.
Feminism has two variations, the ambivalent and the benevolent, where the latter is subtle and gentle. However, the client woman to take care of either things or to be overprotective to safeguard your safety. For example, give up the set. What is your opinion about this?
Today we are in the house of a group of amazing students. To ask them what do they think about benevolent sexism. So, Miss Astrid, could you tell us what do you think about that?
In my opinion, the benevolent sexism is just a generally way to show us the superiority of men to women by actions that we considerate, polite.
Oh, well, thank you so much. But what about you, Mr. Juan Fernando?
The benevolent sexisms in Mexico are instilled in a man like an attitude of chivalry to a woman, but in other parts of the world, those ways of acting are reflected to a nice form to promote the dependent role of the woman. I think so.
Let's see, Miss Katia, what do you have to say?
Oh, that's if I keep a traditional relation of the patriarchal structure and the idea that the man is the strong, the powerful, and intelligent, and the woman doesn't have that characteristics.
Okay, thank you, Miss Katia. And then we are gonna see what Miss Rebecca have to tell us.
Yes, of course. I'm not really sure if I am okay, but I think that an example constantly here for all of us is when Anne says women are just more beautiful by their bodies, and I don't think so. Women and men are equally beautiful human beings, and they both deserve respect and to not be objectified.
Sure, thank you, Miss Rebe. But what do you think, Miss Esperanza?
I think that my classmate said what is an ironic whole side path. In this center, women and men have the same opportunities and possibilities to do whatever they want, but is our problem and some of us let that men or even women can feel bigger.
What do you can say about that?
I could give another example about this, maybe when in a relationship the man is who opened the door for his girlfriend. I think that it's not necessary because I can do it. If he doesn't do that, I will not get angry.
Great, thanks to everyone. That's all. I'm Yolanda reporting to What News.
The next topic on the list is about feminists and patriarchy. You don't know what you really win and position in seconds. Well, I personally, I don't think so. But some women in this side of the world think it. But in other times, some women think if you be a gentleman, you try to subjugate her. Well, we have an interview of my partner, Isabel Osorno. Okay, let's check it.
Hi, I will be asked some question about machism to medical students. I would like to make you some question about machism.
Yes, yes.
Do you think that the gentleman is a kind of machist?
Yes, I know. Because being a gentleman is a macho, but when it is considered a me, next are going to compete with Taylor. Rhodes and women and ladies are the beneficiaries of this act. On the contrary, it will look for some synonyms or for being a gentleman with words that are generosity, loyalty, gentry, gold miners. Among all is sure of it signals that being a gentleman is a plus. Arrogance is different, that is considered magic.
Well, with action of gentlemen are considered magic.
They think because we are women that can do a job with men, that they are the best. In a job where there is no gender equality and salary, they think a woman should be at home, and they say that can help with also, charges of the day shall respect the other women they want to work or study.
How do these acts affect women?
I think this is only a consequence of stereotypes, since stereotypes are the characteristics that are considered appropriate ways, primitive for us and female for them. These stereotypes in turn create gender roles, that is, the way that behave and perform. The daily lives mean any woman.
women play the role of housewives who need protection and make them vulnerable. And when men fulfill the role of protecting, providing, seeing, and loving with women.
I think that there's a line between being kind and then a woman thinks that a man should leave to she his place at the public transportation. It all depends on the position of the woman. If they wait for all the time in places to give them a place, and when the women arrive at a place where this act doesn't happen, they make comments like there are no more gentlemen. Those women are affected by machines. There are men who give their places to a woman, and women see it as an act of help or kindness, and women don't think that a man doesn't do that because he thinks that a woman are weak.
Who will benefit that the society does change?
I think that it will help other forms of discrimination against women and girls, removing the violence against them in the public ambit and private, including the traffic and all forms of exploitation. It will help removing harmful practices as the child marriage force.
Isa reporting to the study.
Violence against women is what is exercised because of her status as a woman. This is a consequence of discrimination it suffers and the persistence of gender inequality. In this violence, there are numerous patterns ranging from discrimination and contempt to physical, sexual, verbal, or psychological aggression are more. What is your opinion about this? Do you think there is only violence towards women?
Hi guys, we're welcome to the university to ask people about if the violence in women existed, or they think the violence is only for women or also for men. Let's go interview.
Hi. Excuse me. One question. What is gender-based violence?
Gender-based violence is based in the imbalance of power existing in gender relations. Most of the evidence shows that in this type of the violence, the victims are mostly women, and males are aggressors. But it also often the other way around.
Have you ever been mixed race? Woman?
No, I rescued him. I could never mistreat that woman.
Thank you. One question. Do you know what is the statistics of violence against women in Mexico?
Not exactly, but someday I read that in Mexico, 66% of women are overall 15 years old, they have experienced some kind of violence
in their work.
Also, I read that according to the OMS, 30% of women have suffered some kind of violence, usually physical or sexual violence, also by their partners.
Oh, thank you. Continuous walking to continue asking you
here.
Hi guys, one question. What are the health consequences of violence in women?
They cause survivors and their children serious physical and psychological, sexual and reproductive problems in the short and long term, and have a high economic and social cost.
Yeah, thank you. One. You are a woman. Can there is real love on the part of a man who physically hurts his partner?
No. A person who mistreats physically, emotionally, economically, or sexually has not love for himself. And therefore,
that
doesn't
help
others.
Thank you. Continue walking to the other woman. A question. For that.
Hi, one question, please. Do you think that men can suffer violence by women?
Yes, the men can suffer physical or emotional violence.
We can be the person who suffer violence. We
can denounce before the authorities because men and women have the same right.
Oh, thank you. When our continuous to ask the more people so hi guys. Hi, well, question. What warning signs could make a woman react to what her partner might have episodes of domestic violence?
Well, I think maybe your partner criticize you or hurt you, or maybe want to have sex or force you. I think that's the signs that you will suffer violence.
Thank you. This is it. I am Annie Rodriguez reporting for What's News.
We know that we are in a modern society, but do you think that moms have to make housework or men can help? What kind of things the men can do? Who should work? Now it's the turn of Gabby Cadena. Gabby, we hear you.
About the machine. What is your name?
My name is Robert.
What do you think about the machine? Do you consider that the machine is already over or still exists
in the family, in the jobs, and I think also that Mexico is a country with a lot of gains of machines.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay.
What is your name? Hi, my name is Rebecca. What do you think about the machine?
I think the machine is present in the family. For example, when the woman only dedicates herself to attending the house and the children and cannot focus on other things of interest.
Yeah, it's very true. Hello guys, what is your name?
Hello, my name is
Hi, my name is Viviana.
My name is Jesus.
What do you think about?
Yes, it still exists and lives hidden in our current society. It surprises the number of women who are mistreated by boyfriends and observing the little respect that there is into the gender equality. I believe that we as women deserve the same value as the society. We must demand it that our rights be respected. We must denounce those who harass, hit, or humiliate others because we deserve to be loved, respected, and understood.
Yeah, it's pretty true. Miss Billy, do you consider that the machine is eradicated or still exists?
Still exists. It is very clear that this state of thinking still exists in the female mind. Focusing on the Mexican woman, they continue to suffer violence and abuse continue with two jobs, the home and the pay, and often do so to have a husband who doesn't meet their obligations.
Yeah, thank you, Billy.
Currently, the inequality in the workplace continues to insult women, discrimination and abuse both physical and physiological. It is very sad to say that many women continue to die because of the maltreatment that comes from machismo. To give so much importance to his wife of raising and not to his intelligence. the one that is under to the woman and say to only service to be come to clean and to raise the children, all this really should change.
Well, today that's all on my part. Thank you very much for your opinion. We return to the forum with you for what's news.
And finally, we can decide if the machismo is over or continues. Let's see some opinions about the public. Oliver, we are with you.
Hello, good morning. Today we are going to interview a family on the subject of women and how work and economic relations. We will see what they say about it. Hello, good morning. How are you?
Hi, good morning.
Today I come from World News. Would you let me do an interview?
Of course, come in.
My husband and Pamela.
Hi.
Good morning.
What do you think about that the woman have the responsibility to take care of the house?
Well, I think it's fine because my whole life has always been, and it is a job that belongs to the woman.
I see that you don't agree with that. What do you think about it?
Well, I'm disagreeing with that because I think that everyone can work and help at home. For example, my husband and I work in the morning, and in the afternoon we do the dish of the house.
Okay. And you, sir, what do you think about the subject?
A woman could stay at home, attending her family. This is responsibility.
Okay, thank you. Is anyone else in the house?
Yes, I know their daughter who is in her room.
With a friend. Okay, can I? Thank you. Hello, good morning. I'm doing an interview. Could you answer me a question, please?
Yes, tell me.
What do you think about that the women have the responsibility to take care of the house?
Well, I finished my career, but I decide not to work. I prefer to stay in the house to take care of my children and clean the house. I like to be here.
Okay, thank you. And who are you?
I am the friend of Aime.
And what do you think about the subject?
I think differently. I always say here that she is a stupid girl because she should work to have their own money and not depend to anyone.
Okay.
She is my other daughter and comes from her job.
Hi.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm doing an interview. Could you answer me a question?
Yes.
What do you think about that the woman have the responsibility to take care of the house?
Well, I think that a woman can do both at the time, but for me it's hard because I have to go to work and take care of my children, and then I need to clean my house all of the times by my own, so it's so difficult.
Okay, thank you for your time. That's gonna be all.
Okay, thanks to you, and see you later.
Thank you. Reporting to What News, that's gonna be all.
That's all for today.
We are What News.
Thanks for watching.
We'll be right back.